Hi everyone, welcome to this getting started tutorial on how to create and configure the Syncfusion React trigger using the create react app command. In this video, I'm going to show you how to add the triggered component to an app using the package Syncfusion EJ2 React triggered and how to enable a few of its important features, paging, sorting, and filtering. Let me show you the application creation process. I will create my app using the create react app toolchain. I will use VS Code as the editor and show you the output in Google Chrome. In VS Code, I need to install the command npm install create react app. As I have already installed this toolchain, I'll skip this step. Then I create a new application using the command create react app and provide the app name triggered component. I set the script version to template TypeScript. I navigate to the desired location and run this sample using the command npm start and show you the start page. Here it's opened and I can edit the app.tsx page to show the triggered here. Next, remove the default code snippets in the app.tsx file and styles in the app.css file. Then I install the Syncfusion triggered package using the command npm install Syncfusion EJ2 React triggered save. Once the package is installed, I will import the material theme styles to the app.css file to apply styles to the triggered component. To start using triggered component, I will import it from the EJ2 React triggered package and then return it within the render method. I cannot view the triggered since there is no data source bound to it. Let's fix that now. I add the file datasource.js and define the summary data for triggered component with fields like ID, name, units, and so on. Look at this data. It contains tasks and subtasks to demonstrate the triggered. Then I import the summary data from the datasource.js file and assign it to the datasource property of the triggered component. Check the triggered. All the fields in the summary data are displayed. Also notice that subtasks are displayed as a field instead of rows and their values are displayed as objects. I want to display it in a separate row. So, I map the subtask field to the child mapping property in the triggered component and set the tree column index to 1 to have an expand button in the name column. Look at the triggered now. Its subtasks are displayed as a separate rows and I can expand or collapse them based on the data from the name column. Now look here, the column names are displayed like the summary data field names. I can customize the column name and display selective columns in the triggered component using the columns directive and use column directive to customize individual column. So I import the columns directive and column directive from the triggered package and define them in triggered component. I include the field property and map the ID field from the summary data. I include the header text property and set its value to ID. In the same way, I define the other fields. I have more options to customize the triggered columns, of which I will show you the basic options now. For the column ID, I customize the default width using the width property. And I align its content by setting the text align property to right. Also, I display currency format in the price column values by setting the format property value to C2. Now look here, the column names are displayed using the columns directive. Next, I'll show you how to enable the paging feature in triggered. Before moving to this, you need to understand the feature module concept of triggered. To make this component lightweight, its features are available as modules and we can use just the required ones. This document contains the complete list of feature modules, and I'll show you a few of them now. To use these modules in TreeGrid, I need to import the inject module from the TreeGrid package. And to use the paging feature, I need to import the page module too. Then I inject the page module in the TreeGrid component. To enable a page view in the TreeGrid, I set the allow paging property to true. Check the TreeGrid, the pager is rendered. Now I will show you how to enable sorting. To use the sorting feature, I need to import the sort module from the EJ2 TreeGrid package. Then I inject the sort module in the TreeGrid component. To enable sorting, I set the allow sorting property to true. Check the TreeGrid when I click the column header, data is sorted in either ascending or descending order. Finally, I'll show you how to enable filtering. To use the filtering feature, I need to import the filter module from the EJ2 TreeGrid package. Then I inject the filter module in the TreeGrid component. To enable filtering, I set the allow filtering property to true. Check the TreeGrid, the filter box is shown, and I can type any text to filter the TreeGrid records. Now, let me quickly recap what we have seen in this video. I showed you how to configure the TreeGrid component and few of its important features in a React app. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. You can also see if you are eligible for a community license, which will get you a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.